little puppy decided to hop up on the bed before I was about to film this video, so I guess he's gonna be in the video with us today. So today I'll be showing you how to take plain and old swimsuits that you might have laying around at your house that you don't really wear anymore, and I'm gonna show you guys how to personalize your swimsuits to make them look like you spent a ton of money on them or you bought them at a boutique, but really you actually just got all of your supplies at Walmart and Joann and Michaels and you made these awesome bathing suits. I'm going to show you how to make a studded bathing suit, a fringe bathing suit, and also a really pretty light pastel tie-dye bathing suit, which they are so affordable to make. If you guys would like to see some more DIY summer videos like this, then make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and then also go down below and comment any requests that you have for DIY summer videos. Oh, and if you guys try out any of these bathing suits, I would love to see them, so make sure you send me a picture on Twitter or Instagram, because that would literally make my day if you guys tried these out. So yeah, I guess with all that being said, we can go ahead and get started with the video, and TiVo is right there in the back. Swag. Let's go. I know it's just something about ya. Got me feeling like I can't be without ya. Anytime someone mention your name, I'll be feeling as if. So here's what we're gonna need for this studded swimsuit top. You're going to obviously need a swimsuit top. Mine's from Target. You're going to need some studs. I got mine from Michaels. And you're also going to need some glue. I'm using E6000 glue that I got at Joann. So all I'm doing is taking my stud, putting some glue on it, and then pressing it down onto my swimsuit. Guys, it's really that easy. This is the easiest one out of all of them. So the thing that I love about this swimsuit the most is instead of just using all of the same shape studs, I'm using all different kinds of shapes and sizes. So I'm using a round stud, I'm using a small square stud, and a large square stud, and putting it on as a diamond. I think by doing this, it just added so much more to the bathing suit instead of just doing all the same studs. But to you, you can do whatever you want. Personally, I am just in love with this bathing suit. I think it turned out amazing. I've never seen a swimsuit actually like this, so I'm so happy with the way that it turned out, and I'm going to be wearing this swimsuit top so much this summer, so it's just flipping awesome, guys. You again, you are my homie, lover, and friend. Exactly why you light me up inside. Can I call wake you up on a Sunday late night? I think we need. Alright guys, now we're to the fringe top, and all you're going to need is a swimsuit top, preferably a bandeau. Mine's from Target. You're also going to need some fabric. I got mine from Joann. You're going to need some beads. You're also going to need a needle and matching thread. That is very important. Don't get like the wrong color thread. And then this is totally optional, but I decided to add this really pretty embellishment to mine. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna take our scissors and we're going to be cutting all the strips for the fringe, and you're just going to want to do your best to cut straight lines. That way our fringe looks really good, and you can make your fringe as thin as you want it, as long as you want it, as short as you want it, as thick as you want to make it. It's totally up to you, but this is just how I'm making mine, so I'm just showing you guys here that. The next thing that you're gonna do is just take your fringe, and I'm just pulling my fringe. I don't know, does that make sense? Yeah, it does. But I'm just pulling all of my fabric to make the fringe look better. And then you're gonna take your needle and your thread, and you're just going to be sewing on the fringe to the top of your swimsuit. Now, this does take some time. You could fabric glue it, but I mean, it would be pretty embarrassing if you were at the pool or the beach and your fringe like just fell off. I mean, that'd be pretty bad. So that's why I decided to sew mine on. And then I'm also taking the embellishment and sewing that over top. It's great because it covers up any sew marks or any thread marks. Yeah, thread marks that you have. And it just adds so much to the swimsuit top. It makes it look, I think, even more expensive. So that's why I did that. And then the last thing you're gonna do is just take your beads. You can use any color you want. You could even add more beads on if you wanted to each piece of fringe. And you're just gonna tie a little knot at the end, and voila. Now we have this amazing swimsuit top. Every time I look at this swimsuit top, it makes me like so proud of myself, because I think it came out so amazing, and I think that it looks like you bought it at a boutique or somewhere online and you paid a ton of money for it. So this is something that you guys can definitely do, because if I can do it, you can do it. You could even do it with your friends, and you guys could do opposite colors, so when you go to the pool or the beach, you guys could be twinning, and it would be completely flipping fabulous. Your picture perfect blue, sunbathing on the moon, stars shining as you ball. So this is the last swimsuit I'm going to show you guys how to make. So you're going to need a white swimsuit. I got mine at Target. You're also going to need some tie-dye. I have teal, purple, and pink. So the first thing you're going to want to do is take your swimsuit, and you're going to want to make sure that it is damp. So I just ran it under the sink, and then I squeezed out all of the excess water. It's really important that we have our swimsuit damp, because you don't want to tie-dye it when it is completely dry. So now you can take your gloves and put them on, which, by the way, my gloves were so bad. I used the gloves that came with the tie-dye kit, so don't do that, because I got tie-dye all over my hands anyways. But yeah, so you're just gonna take your purple tie-dye and you're gonna put that at the bottom, or whatever color you guys decide to use. And then I'm taking my tealish blue tie-dye and I am putting that in the middle, because blue and teal and all that kind of stuff, all those blue colors, they're my favorite colors out there, you know. And then I'm taking my pink tie-dye and I'm putting that at the top. And I just want to let you guys know that this tie-dye actually went through on the back, so I didn't have to flip my bottoms over and re-put it on the back, so it was just like perfect. And then I did the same thing to my swimsuit top. I put purple on the bottom, I did the tealish blue in the middle, and then I did pink all on the top, and I also decided to do pink on the straps as well. So once you have completed dyeing your top and your bottoms, you're gonna want to let your bathing suit sit for about 24 hours at the least. That's what I did. And then you're going to take it once it's done setting, and you're going to put extremely hot water on in your sink. Wash it out in your sink, as I'm doing here. By using hot water, that's what's going to set all of the dye. I know there's other ways that you can do this, but this is how I've always tie-dyed even shirts and everything. So as you can see, the bottoms and the top were really dark, but once you wash out all the tie-dye, it is just, oh my gosh, the most beautiful pastel colors, like blue, a purpley pink color. And then you're just going to want to put your bathing suit in the dryer on low delicate for about 40 minutes, because that's what I did. And once it's done drying, you're ready to go out and rock this. So you guys can obviously do any colors that you have, but we have a gorgeous pastel bathing suit right here. And I'm so happy with the way it turned out, because I'm always looking for a tie-dye bathing suit when I go shopping for bathing suits, and I can never find one. I don't know why, but now I have the perfect one. It like blew me away when the colors came out, because they're so beautiful. So I'm sure you guys are wondering, Jess, where is your necklace from? It is from onenecklace.com, and it's a beautiful monogram necklace with my initials on it. And because I love this necklace so much, I have a coupon code for you guys, so you should definitely go check out onenecklace.com. I'll have their link in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope that it helped you out in a way. Don't forget to send me pictures on Twitter or Instagram if you try any of these DIY bathing suits out. And if you guys aren't subscribed to my channel already, then make sure you go down and hit that subscribe button, because that would be pretty swag. I'm just saying, like, join the family. What up? I don't really know what I'm doing, but you should go and subscribe to my channel. And yeah, that's it. I love you guys so much. Remember to smile, because you're beautiful, and I'm always here for you if you need someone to talk to. So I guess I will see you guys in my next video, which will probably be next week. See you guys later. Bye. Pop that thing, she gonna pop that.